experience the cage.
Illan toinen ottelu käydään painoluokassa 63 kiloa. Our referee in charge of the octagon in this catchweight fight is Mika Moukari Sinkkonen. Ladies and gentlemen, to the blue corner, Hama Dara!
Hit him with a little ghetto gospel.
Those who wish to follow me,
my ghetto gospel,
I welcome with my hands. And the red sun sinks last into the hills of gold. A peace to this young warrior.
Here we have Hama Dara making his way to the cage. Weighing in at 63.4 kilograms at this, or for rather, this 63 kilo catchweight bout. He has officially missed weight. That won't slow down his fast kicks. That won't stop his scrambles. And that won't stop him from piecing people up from the outside. But what it will do is it will forfeit a bit of his purse to Kari Itkonen here tonight, Alexi.
And Hama Dara hasn't had a lot of success yet as a professional, but he has a really long frame, he has a lot of tools, and both his first fights were taken on a really short notice. We last saw him on early December on Cage 56, and he took the fight on 2 days' notice, and still it ended up being a split decision. So he is a competitor, and for this fight he is coming with a full camp.
Right, the record doesn't always say it all, right? So, you know, both of these fighters here tonight, you have to think it is a bit do or die for that MMA career. 0-2 isn't the best, but as you said, both fights on short notice and came in on 2 days' notice for that last fight. That's wild to me.
Yeah, he is a warrior through and through. But you can say the same about his opponent, Kari Itkonen.
That 2 days' notice is just sticking in the back of my head like a thorn. It's like, I won't even go on a nature walk with less than 2 days' notice. This is definitely an interesting matchup here tonight, though. Hama Dara having some very, very solid kicks. Likely going to look to control the pace of the fight from the distance. He does have a reach advantage here tonight as well.
Yeah, he has a really tall and long frame for a bantamweight, or a natural bantamweight, because being 182 centimeters tall, which is like, really tall for this division.
Yeah.
And he uses that frame relatively well.
Yeah, great wingspan on him. And I mean, you know, he does also come from an incredible, well, those kicks are on full display in his little pre-fight warm-up here. And, you know, he fights out of the Finn Fighters gym, where he has, you know, Tipi Hirvikangas in his corner.
To the red corner, Kari Itkonen!
Versatile kickboxer, and he's looking to even up the kind of record here, take his professional career to 2-3, a bit better victory ratio here tonight.
And Goddard is a really experienced competitor, and yours truly, me, I've actually competed with Kari in the amateur ranks, I think it was 2012 or something. So
wow, that's incredible.
So I'm over a year retired, and Goddard is still like going on strong. So he's very experienced kickboxer, competed long time, kickboxing, grappling, amateur MMA. So that's why, and he is doing a bit of everything at the moment for Finnish MMA scene. He's competing actively as a professional fighter. He's putting together amateur tournaments. It's kind of like everywhere a little bit
right
now.
Yeah, that's true love for the game.
Exactly, and we need a lot of guys like him to build up the scene, and he's doing a lot of great work in addition to being an athlete.
Yeah, and you can see that he also surrounds himself by other veterans of the game. In his corner, you have Anton Kuivinen, who is obviously a UFC veteran and just a legendary figure in Finnish MMA. Storied history in the sport, and here he is, making his fifth appearance in the cage. He will give up a slight reach advantage and a slight height advantage to Hamadara, who also will, of course, look to use those kind of wild kicks he's got to make the most of that that length and that distance.
In the blue corner, fighter with a professional record of 2 losses, weighing 63.4 kilos, representing in Fine Fighters Gym, fighter of Turku, Finland, Hamadara! In the red corner, fighter with a professional record of 1 win and 3 losses, weighing 63 kilos, representing GB Gym and Primus Fight Team, fighting out of Helsinki, Finland, Kari Itkonen!
Hamadara versus Kari Itkonen here tonight in Helsinki. Hamadara looking to get his first taste of victory, and Kari Itkonen looking to add another win to his record. Alexi, what are you looking for in this matchup?
I think this will come down to Hama trying to control the distance, as you say, with the fast kicks, long frame. And Kari has stated in the interviews previously, he will try to get on the inside, use his kickboxing to close the distance, and then use his heavy top control, which actually got him his first professional win last year.
Dara already opened up with a kick up high. He's using that length to kind of gauge the distance here. Some feints. Same can be said for Kari Itkonen though.
Hama switching stances here early. I like when he was going southpaw, because as a good kicker and a fast kicker, this gives him the option to use the rear leg to kick the open side. As you can see, he hurt Kari a little bit.
Yeah, he touched that liver, I think. That's not a feeling that anyone is a fan of, least of all Kari Itkonen, because now he's getting those elbows just dropped on him.
Sami Sakko, who is the head coach of the competition team at Finn Fighters Gym, calling for elbows in Hamadara's corner.
I would agree with those calls. Those first couple seemed to really clang off the old dome there of Kari Itkonen, and that's a good way to get a finish, specifically if you want to kind of make an impression in that first victory of your career.
Kari is angling out a little bit off of the cage. Hama is not really having a good hip control, so Kari has a good chance to build for an armbar or switch to a leg attack.
And considering his wealth of experience in competition, you know, that's one of those reads that I think having a long history with the sport really gives you.
Yeah, but Dara turned really well, trying to go for the back, but he is a little bit high. With that long, lanky frame, I think he has a chance to go for triangles or arm locks. A bit of like a reverse triangle or falling off arm lock from here, but he is not going to maintain this back position. And now Kari gets on top.
Yep, Kari Itkonen now with the top position, looking to even the score with a couple of elbows of his own, perhaps. Maybe a little bit of ground and pound, but instead decides to grab a hold of that neck. What does he need to do to finish this as a choke here?
He can try to get his hip in, but I don't think he's actually looking to finish this here.
This
I think
control.
It's more of just control wearing on Hamadara and looking to go behind as he did here.
Yeah, it looks like he will try and take the back, or rather he has done so, and now potentially will look to get in those hooks. You know, the pace here has been actually quite urgent. You know, so...
Yeah, Connerty's loot now, he lost the hip connection or chest-to-back connection for a moment, and Dara has a good chance to turn here facing Kari and getting the top position back as he does now. A good scramble. The back control on both athletes is a little bit hasty, so they are falling off a little bit, not focusing perfectly on the grips, but at least we're getting a lot of reversals here.
Yeah, lots of scrambles makes for exciting fights for sure.
I think physically, Kari is a little bit more stronger athlete of the two, but Dara is using his long frame very well to maintain control in some of these positions. And you got to be careful with these. With long arms like Dara's, he can go for anacondas or front chokes from this position.
Yeah, dangerous to leave your head in there with someone who has that length of reach.
Well played by Kari. He was really looking to, hunting that single leg, getting his head inside and immediately pulling Dara down, getting back to top position.
Itkonen back in top position, but this could also be a pretty dangerous spot. You know, he's got that one arm in. Could make for, that up kick looks to have hurt Kari Itkonen. Itkonen pushing the head of Dara up towards the cage. I did see a bit of a fence grab there from Hamadara earlier. Itkonen once again regains composure in that top position. Very, very back and forth first round here tonight for these two.
Yeah, Dara is going for a last 15 seconds building for a triangle choke here, but I think Itkonen is very wary of the time here, so he's not really stressing about getting out of this position.
Yeah, there's not a lot. That's not a lot of time to do much of anything. From the bottom. Excellent back and forth first round. Lots of scrambles there, and good top control from Kari Itkonen.
Wait, I have to say, I'd still give the round to Hamadara with the early body kick that really hurt Itkonen.
Right.
And he landed some of those nice elbows. Even though Itkonen had a bit more control time, I think the damage was definitely on Hamadara's side.
Yeah, that body kick really got him backing up. And the kick that followed, I mean, Kari Itkonen went down. Now, with Hamadara missing weight, you gotta wonder what went wrong in the camp. It wasn't by much, it was, you know, 400 grams, whatever the case may be, but you do have to wonder, how is his conditioning gonna be here tonight?
Hey, he looks a little bit winded. I think Kari looks pretty fresh. And he has gone three five-minute rounds before and stayed very fresh throughout the fight. Mm. So he is experienced and he knows how to pace himself very well. Yep. And you can kind of see that in his fighting. I don't think he went all in on those grappling exchanges yet. I think he might be trying to wear Dara out a little bit and go for a late finish.
And when you look at the physicality difference, like Kari Itkonen does appear to be, you know, the thicker fighter here.
Yeah.
Oddly enough, despite the fact that he made the weight clean. And he goes for a takedown.
That was way off, that takedown. Yeah. Really, really far out. But he still got to the legs. I think that shows that Dara might be a little bit tired, not reacting to that shot very well. But
right, the fast twitch is kind of burned up, maybe.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
He dropped that elbow, though, that left elbow, right into the ear or temple of Kari Itkonen. That's a dangerous spot to be in. Not something you can really sustain many of. I didn't get a chance to see Kari Itkonen's composure in the corner. My angle was just bad because I had a former UFC fighter and legend in my way in Anton Koivunen.
And that is wide back and big shoulders to look behind to. But I don't know what actually happened there. It looked a little bit to me like Kari was pulling guard. Maybe he was a bit outbalanced and lost the top position. He had a good control of the toes, pushed Hamon to the cage, but
I feel like there's a difference here between the positional control of Kari Itkonen and the positional control that Hamadara displays. You know, when Kari Itkonen is on top, it looks a little bit more composed, but here you have Kari Itkonen now on that, in that bottom position, bloodied. One of those elbows seems to have snuck through in a way that has, quite frankly, sliced him open. Bit of a potential for a neck crank, but no clean choke there, to my understanding. Hamadara doesn't particularly be looking to... Oh, there he goes. Sets up a pass to half guard. Looks to be working to pin Kari Itkonen up against the cage.
That was a very, very smart circling back to the hips. Now he's going for an arm triangle.
He's got that cage there, though, so, I mean, that might make things difficult, but it could also give him something to push off.
I mean, Kari, at the moment, at least, Kari's elbow is wide open, so I don't think Hama is getting that very tight. And the cage is... He is on the right side to finish this, but the cage is blocking him a little bit, right. So Kari still can get the... Could get the opposite side hook between Dara's leg and kind of control the distance, or not let that strangle get tight enough for the finish.
Once again, though, Kari Itkonen pushes him back into a spot where it's more appropriate for him to be able to control him. And Hamadara looks to attempt to perhaps pass again here.
This round has been very different from the first round.
Yeah,
now,
absolutely.
This has been all about ground control. In all honesty, I thought if this turned into a controlled ground fight, it would be Kari Itkonen in top position.
Right.
And I thought Dara has a chance with the scrambles and attacking the neck and back control and things like this, and especially the striking and the fast kicks. But he's really showing that he can also maintain top position well and control Kari.
This is a grueling style of fight, though. You know, lots of elbows thrown here. Kari Itkonen from the back, Hamadara earlier, an elbow that split open Kari Itkonen. This is an exhausting pace, too.
Yeah, this might not look like the most exciting exchange of techniques, but it is tiring and grueling.
Yeah, absolutely.
Now, Kari has a deep underhook on the left side, so he should be able to get up from this position. He might be trying to set up a knee bar here. No, he's trying to go for the traditional dogfight half-guard sweep and decided to recover guard, which, maybe he's trying to just ride out the round, but overall might not be the best plan.
Yeah.
Stay in the bottom and recover guard. But
yeah, specifically, depending on, you know, how did the judges see that first round? Was that kind of a, I guess you could call it a knockdown or a sit-down if you want to, from Hamadara to Kari Itkonen? Like, if that won him the round, this round is definitely in his favor as well. So this could be a very bad spot for Kari Itkonen to be in going into the third. And by the look of those shots, it most definitely is. Oh, another hard elbow.
Very hard ground and pound to finish the round by Hamadara.
Itkonen did appear to be kind of protesting a little bit that maybe some of those shots were not clean. Let's see what happens here. He is cut, but he's got the right guy in his corner to help that. That pace was very, very hard. You know, so it will be interesting to see if Hamadara, you know, is kind of a bit winded. That man tending to the battle wound of Kari Itkonen, that cut, is the legendary Tippi Hirvikangas, who is the cage cut man. And a just well-respected figure in the MMA community here in Finland. I'm seconds have been ordered out at this time. But still, Hamadara's quarterman was waving him down with the flag, trying to cool him off a bit. This third and final round between Hamadara and Kari Itkonen. And Hamadara looks to take control of the position on the feet early.
Kari is again looking for the same position, going for the single leg or low single, hiding his leg behind Dara, trying to scramble to top position. Not successful this time.
Hamadara takes the back. Let's see if he's able to do anything with the position.
I think the second round gave a lot of confidence to Dara, because I think the risk with Itkonen was that he's stronger, he might be able to utilize top control like he did in his first pro win. But when Dara is able to control Kari like this, I think that's that gives him a big, big morale boost.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, and you know, he's still keeping a quick pace. He looks, for lack of a better word, very, very motivated to finish this fight even.
And now, even though in that back control moment, Dara was really, really high on that, Kari is not reacting to these at all. So I think he might be tired or a little bit out of it from those short elbows or heavy ground and pound strikes in the previous round.
If you're tired, this is not a spot you want to be in, right?
Definitely.
You've got Hamadara on your back
with a body triangle.
Punches, yeah, with a body triangle. Now, again, some of the pressure is off because he has turned to that side. But look, he's wrenching on your guts. Like, that's not something you want, regardless of how minimal the pressure might be. And now, this looks to be only getting worse for Kari Itkonen. Hamadara winging punches in. Kari Itkonen trying to defend, though. Fighting hands. Hamadara potentially looking for a rear naked choke here.
In order to break the body triangle, Kari can try to just turn and face Dara, but with someone who can actually control the position, it is very, very, very difficult. So there's basically,
hard shots.
There's two basic options. One is stand up and move against the cage, which starts to wear on the legs of the one hanging on the body triangle. And the other one, he needs to grab the leg that is locking. So it would be Hamadara's left leg, which is kind of extended,
right,
in controlling the triangle. He needs to get that inside, pull it up to open up the lock, and then try to turn and face Dara. But with just scrambling and turning, the lock is not going anywhere.
Right. Yeah, and you know, I'm inclined to say perhaps that lock is not going anywhere. Kari Itkonen at this point has fought, valiantly, but this is pretty exhausting. Very high pace. And after some of those shots he took, he might not be entirely there.
And in this position with Dara on top, whether it's turtled or flattened out, you can land really, really hard strikes. And you saw how Dara was able to land when they were kind of like a half on the mat, or he was like half on the bottom, half on top, kind of like a now. He was landing hard ground and pound. I think in these positions, if he can push and turn to top position while maintaining that back control, he could have a good chance of finishing the fight.
Yeah, those shots were absolutely brutal. Oh, I mean, man. It was just fire and fury from Hamadara. Now, does he have the energy to do more of that after a match like this? Back and forth, lots of high intensity, very, very kind of grueling pace for both fighters. We'll see. 1 minute remaining, or under, rather. Here you have just Hamadara quietly working away, looking for potential openings, trying to mount some offense. Hovering with that arm, just waiting for the opportunity. And now he wails away. He doesn't care that that arm is in between. He's going to hit whatever he can hit, and he's just going to leave it all out there tonight. And I think that that was enough to get him his first professional victory.
I agree. I think in my books, he won all three rounds.
I could agree with that assessment as well. And, you know, he's quite young, only 24 years of age. So plenty of time to, you know, with that first victory, very ostensibly in the books here tonight, lots of time to right this ship and continue on that kind of trek to the top.
And as I said, I really like that Hama takes fights on short notice. That shows his bravery, his willingness to compete. But
strategically,
exactly. But with a full camp,
yeah,
this is what he can do. This is like the level he can perform at, which is, in my opinion, way higher than we saw in his previous fight.
Yeah, I would agree with that assessment. Now, here's some furious ground and pound that Hamadara delivered. Another thing that I thought was quite interesting is, you know, Kari Itkonen having that leg bent and Hamadara having the kind of, you know, foresight to kick it and really just take the leg out from him, you know, earlier in the fight. That was very intriguing. Lots of good positional control, which you might not have guessed would have actually been the case, you know, just looking at the kind of stats on the sheet of paper. But Hamadara went in there, you know, fire and fury, and really put on a hell of a performance.
Yeah, I really like that performance.
Yeah.
Smart, intelligent fights, a lot of pressure coming in, looking for his first professional victory.
Now, one thing you do want to see, perhaps in the future, make that weight.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, but other than that, very, very stellar performance, and I think it was enough to get him the victory here tonight. Good show of sportsmanship here as well. And I mean, Kari Itkonen is wearing the damage as well. You know, it looks like a couple of different cuts, perhaps one on the bridge of the nose, you know, a very, very swollen left orbital, and a cut somewhere near the hairline on that right side. It's safe to say that Hamadara, you know, put him to the test tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of fighting, winner by unanimous decision, Hamadara!
There you have it, Hamadara, winner by way of unanimous decision, but he wants to hear a big round of applause for Kari Itkonen as well, which you'll love to see. Excellent show of sportsmanship. Now we go live to the interview with Hamadara.
Onneksi olkoon hieno voitto, täyteen aikaan mentiin.
Kiitos.
Niin kuin äsken jo tuossa lyhyesti juteltiin, niin Kari on todella sitkeä ottelija ja yritit kyllä monelta kantilta, sekä pystyssä että matossa, mutta ei mennyt kesken, mutta hieno voitto sieltä tuli.
Kiitos. Piti tarkistaa monen otteeseen, että mitä ihmet, onks mä ihmisen selässä vai karhun selässä, vittu, huhuu.
Minkälaisella suunnitelmalla sä itse lähit tähän otteluun aluperin?
Joo. Tämän matsin teema oli rentous. Ottaa vähän rennommin nyt. Ei oo vierasta, että jos on 40 matsia alla, niin miksi mä jännittäisin? Kato Aso, mä oon meen. Avaan, aamuzajan. Braimen.
Onneksi olkoon, hieno voitto.
Kiitos, kiitos kulttuuritalo. Vähän ääntä. Please, mä oon meen. Kiitos. Kiitos. Kiitos vielä vastustajalle Kari Itkoselle. Otin matsin, vaikka missäsin vähän painoista. Kaikki kunnia hänelle. Kiitos.
Hamadara!
Good pop from the crowd earlier. For I'm a little slow on the uptake, Alexei. How about you help me out? What did he say there?
He said the theme of the fight was relaxation and trying to get the performance, the best performance out of him. That way, he also thanked his opponent, Kari Itkonen, for accepting the fight and apologizing for missing weight. Was very excited and happy with his performance and said he had to check from time to time that was he on top of punching a bear or a man because he couldn't get Kari finished.
Okay, well, I mean, you know, a lot to be proud of in that performance. So I think it's a good sign of things to come for Hamadara, but I can't say that I agree the theme of that fight being relaxation in terms of that was all action. So for me, that was quite intense. Very exciting fight. Very great performance from both men.